Okay. yesterday we have also discussed about frequent item set generation strategies, and among that, one technique is reducing the number of candidates. And how we can reduce that? So that is based on, I think, is the screen is visible to you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So let us see how we can reduce the number of candidates. So whenever we are generating, we need to find the frequent items. Yeah, someone is, interrupting. I think you can sit in a separate place so that it will not be disturbed to others. So we can reduce the number of candidates using a priori principle. It says that an item set is frequent, then all of its subsets must also be frequent. What is the meaning of it? See, for example, let us take an example. Okay. Assume that, I think this screen is visible, right? Is it
yes,
visible?
Yes.
Yeah. Assume that so. CDE, yeah, CDE is a frequent item set. Then its subsets, which are the subsets of CDE?
B, C, B.
C, D, yeah. One is D, one more is C, one more is C, D, and one more is D, E, C, and null. Right. Are you understanding, right?
Yes, sir.
If C, D is frequent, then its subsets, C, D, C, E, D, E, or it's one item set, subsets C, D, E, or null, etc. All are also frequent, except null. Null we should not consider. So this is what is a priori principle. If an item set is frequent, then all of its subsets must also be frequent. And a priori principle holds, if we are representing in a mathematical way, for all x, y, x is a subset of y, then support of x, which is always greater than or equal to support of y. Now, what is S of y? S of y is a superset. S of x is a subset. So, its subset's support will be always greater than or equal to the y value. Are you understanding? If x, y is a frequent item set, then its subset x is its subset. So support of x will be always greater than or equal to support of y. So even if you are not able to understand this expression, we'll discuss further by taking few more examples. That time it will be clear to you. And support of item set never exceeds the support of its subset. In other way, if you are saying the same expression in other way, the support of an item set never exceeds the support of its subsets. And this property is known as anti-monotone. Anti-monotone. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, in order to illustrate this, if we are saying the same principle in some other way, if a certain items are found to be infrequent, like previously we have discussed by taking the example CDE, its subsets are also frequent, right? In other way, if you are saying, if some items are found to be infrequent, then its supersets also are infrequent. Which are the supersets of AB? Yeah, I want your answer. Which are the supersets of AB? I am waiting for your answer.
ABC.
ABC.
ABD.
ABD.
ABC.
ABE. Yeah. AB. And further? AB. Whichever is having AB. Yeah. ABCD, ABC, ABDE, ABCDE. Understood, no? All these are supersets. They are also infrequent. Is it clear? So this a priori principle, I can say in two way. If some items are found to be frequent, then its subsets are frequent. Or if a particular item set is found to be infrequent, then its supersets are also infrequent. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And this is known as pruned supersets. Means pruning means we are further applying the rules for the supersets. Thereby, we are eliminating the infrequent superset items. Now next, we are going to discuss about this a priori principle only. Now consider a item set transaction. Frequent item set transactions we need to find out. But given transaction set, which is having the items, how many items are there in this transaction table?
Five
items. Yesterday we have discussed, right? Now the items are bread, coke, milk, then beer, diaper, and eggs. Now first, we need to find out one item sets. So one item sets is, in item set, there should be only one item. So one is bread, coke, milk, beer, diaper, X. And accordingly, we need to find out their support. Now, how many support means how many times the frequency of occurrence of a particular item. So bread, how many times it is occurring in this transaction set?
Four
times. Four. That's why count is four. Then next is coke. How many times?
Two times. Two times.
Yeah. One second. Okay. Two times it is coke is shown right here. Next is milk.
Four times.
Yeah, four times. One, two, three, four times. Okay. Then beer three times. And diaper four times. Egg one. And
one.
While what is the definition of frequent item set? The item set whose support is greater than or equal to minimum support. Now, in this example, the minimum support is given as a
three.
So that's why we need to eliminate those item sets which do not have support three. Which are the items which do not have support 3?
Coke and X.
Yeah, coke and
X.
Yeah, this do not have support. That's why we need to eliminate. Okay. So, if you are considering a brute force approach means, we need to list all one item sets, two item sets, three item sets. So, the number of candidate item sets will be 6E1, right? Total six items are there. 6C1, combination of one item. Again, combination of two items if you are forming. Again, combination of three items if you are forming. So, total possible item sets to be considered is 6E1 plus 6E2 plus 6C3. Is it clear to you why we are doing this 6E1, 6E2, and 6E3? Give me the answer.
Combinations.
Yeah, combination. One item set, two item sets, three item sets. So total 41. But the support-based pruning, if you are applying support-based pruning, support-based means first we need to count the support, right? So thereby we can reduce this number. Let us see how we can reduce it. Now first, so this is understood now, this part. Is it clear, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Next is, from this, we need to join the same items pair by means of possible pairs which are not and which are having the support, which are having support, these four, right? Is it clear? Whatever highlighted, except coke and eggs, we need to again do the joining operation. Joining means bread and milk, bread and beer, bread and diaper. Understood? Understood or not?
Understood.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Bread and milk, bread and... See, now we need to generate two item set. How to generate? So, one item set is here. Bread and milk, bread and beer, bread and diaper. Next. Beer and...
Milk and beer.
Milk and beer.
Milk.
Yeah. Milk and diaper. Another possibility. Diaper. One more possibility is beer and...
Diaper. Beer and diaper.
Is it clear, right? We have to generate,
yes, sir,
candidates involving coke. Sorry, not involving coke. So other than coke and eggs, we need to generate. So here, how many are there? Six. Instead of 15, now it is reduced to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Next, after doing this, what we have to do is, we need to again find the support count. How to find the support count again? Now we need to find out in the transaction database, where is the, I think this transaction database is, I think you better to write, you have written in your pen, using pen and paper. Please write now. Please write now. I think hardly 2 minutes are required. Just write this only, this part, transaction database. Written? So my voice is audible, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Screen is not visible.
This screen is not visible.
Green color, sir, something.
Yeah?
No, sir.
Green is not
green visible. Color, something.
It is showing green color.
Now it is visible.
Now it is visible, no?
Yes, sir.
So in the first transaction, bread and milk is there. Second transaction, beer, bread, diaper, eggs. Third transaction, beer, coke, diaper, milk. Fourth transaction, beer, bread, diaper, milk. Fifth transaction, bread, coke, diaper, milk. I think this much you have to write. You written? You written, no?
Wait, sir.
Yeah. Had to wait. Done?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let me continue. Now we need to compute the support count. Now in the transaction table, you can refer the table, whatever you written. Bread and milk, how many times it is occurring? Count. Bread and milk together.
Once.
Huh? Only once.
Three times,
right? Similarly, beer and bread is how many times?
Two times,
write that. bread and diaper.
Three times.
Beer and milk.
Two times.
Diaper and milk.
Three.
Beer and diaper.
Three times.
Okay. Next, what you have to do is we need to eliminate those item sets whose support count is less than minimum support. So which are the items which will be eliminated, which are highlighted here?
Beer, bread.
Yeah, this
beer, bread and beer milk.
Yeah, this will be eliminated. That's why we'll have only four possibilities for four candidate possibilities for three item sets. Now the possibilities we need to again write. Now from this, these two are eliminated. So bread, milk and diaper, one possibility. Then one more possibility, bread, milk and beer. Then again bread, diaper and milk. Bread, diaper and milk. One more is beer,
milk, diaper.
So
diaper.
Possibilities we need to write. Then we need to continue the support count. So support count again, no, it is not supporting, right? Support count is all less than the minimum support. That's why the frequent items, whatever are, only these which are having the support. So like this, the Aprori principle is applied. Because if the item sets are infrequent, then we need not to further go and see for the supersets. Or in other way, if bread and milk are found to be frequent, then it's subsets. Which are subsets? Only bread or only milk are also frequent. I hope it's clear to you.
Yes, sir.
Now, next we are going to discuss about a priori algorithm. So, in the a priori algorithm is a seminal algorithm. Seminal means decisive or seminal algorithm proposed by R. Agarwal and R. Srikant in 1994 for mining frequent item sets. And as its name implies, it uses the prior knowledge of frequent item properties. So based on the prior knowledge, it will decide which are the next frequent item sets. So a priori employs an iterative approach known as level-wise search, where the k items are used to explore next k plus 1 item sets. First, the set of one frequent item set is found by scanning the database. I think just now you did the same. By scanning the database, one item set is found. And then we need to find out the support, minimum support. And whichever are having minimum support will be the resultant. And this is denoted by L1. So L1 is one frequent item set. Similarly, from the L1, because in L1 we'll eliminate the items which are infrequent, means which are, do not have support count. So next, what we'll do is, in the next level, from L1, we will explore L2. And L2 will be having two frequent item sets. Next is, we'll find three item sets, L3, until no more frequent K item sets are found. This is what is the a priori algorithm. I think by this mathematical representation you may not be able to understand properly, we'll take an example and we'll discuss. Now, let us see this algorithm. F of k is a frequent k item set, L of k is a candidate k item set. Let k1, k equal to 1, first generate F1, means first one frequent item sets we need to generate. Then we need to continue this until frequent item set of k is empty. First generate the candidate item set from previous frequent item set. From F of k, we need to generate L of k value for the next level. See, from one item set, we are generating two item set. Then next is candidate pruning. Pruning means we are eliminating the item sets from there which are infrequent, we are eliminating. And we need to find the support counting of the candidate keys, sorry, candidate item sets. Then finally, the candidate which are not having enough support, they will be eliminated. So this loop will repeat until there is no more frequent item set with the k items. F of k means it is first k will be 1, next k will be 2, 2 item set, then 3 item set, then 4 item set. Like this it goes until there is no items found with that level which is not having minimum support. The algorithm ends. I think it is not still clear to you. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let us take an example. Then it will be clear to you. If further it is not clear, then we'll see. We'll take more discussion. We'll have some more discussion. And you can note down this transaction table. So note down this transaction table, TID, list of items, T100, I1, I2, I5, T200, I2, I4, T300, I2, I3, T400, I1, I2, I4. So like this, write this transaction database and also minimum support will be given. Write this. Yeah, Neha, any doubt?
No, sir.
I hope you are writing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Vincent, is it clear to you?
Yes, sir. Yashit is present. Yes, sir.
Okay.
ഇതുവരെ കരളെ പ്രിയ മൊഴി അത് പകരും
Okay, done.
Yes, sir.
Now, so first we need to scan the database for one item set. Now we need to find out from this transaction table, we need to find out how many items are there. How many items are there in this? I1 is one item, I2 is another item, I5 is another item, 3, then 4, then I3. Total 5 items are there, right?
5.
Yeah, 5 items. So initially we need to scan the database for count of each candidate. So we need to generate the candidate item set. We need to list the item set. One item set we need to list. So I1, here it is listed. You can see here. It is listed here. I1, I2, I3, I4, I5 is listed over here. Like this, we need to list. After listing, we need to find out how many times I1 is appearing in the transaction set. How many times the I1, how many times it is appearing? I1 once, twice, three times, four times, five times, six times it is appearing. That's why support count is 6. Right. Similarly, I2, how many times it is appearing? Answer is given 7 times. I3, 6 times. I4, 2 times. I5, 2 times. Then we need to compare the support count with the minimum support. What is the minimum support given?
2.
So minimum support is given as a 2. That's why all will be frequent. All will be frequent here. One item set will be frequent. So all I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, all are frequent. So after doing so, at the next level, we'll get L1, right? From L1, we need to generate 2 candidate item sets. Now we need to see the possibilities by joining L1 with L1. Are you understanding? Join L1 with the L1, that is I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, I1, I5. Understood? Next is I2, I3, I2, I4, I2, I5. Next is I3, I4. I3, I4, next I3, I5. Last one is I4 and I5. So like this, we need to list. Is it visible? Yes. Understood, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Next, we need to find, see, I1, I2 is listed, no, here. Now we need to see that in this table, how many times I1, I2 together it is coming. So I1, I2 is here once it is occurred, then I1 and I2 twice, I1, I2 three times, I1 and I2 four times. That's why its support count is 4. Is it clear?
Yes. Is
it clear? Sir. Yeah. Similarly, for I2, I3, I2, I3, we need to see, scan the database. I2, I3, once, twice, then three times here, I2 and I3, then one more, I1, I3, total four times, right? That's why support count is four. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I1 and I4, how many times? I1, I4. I1, I4. It's only appearing two times. That's why it, I1, I4, 1. Similarly, we need to list all these. I think this is understood, no? This part?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
In the next level, what we have to do is, we need to eliminate or prune these items whichever are not having minimum support. So minimum support is given as a 2. That's why eliminate the items which are having less than 2. So that's why this will be eliminated. Which one? I1 and? One second.
I4.
I1 and I4 will be eliminated. Then one more is
I3, I5.
These four will be eliminated. These four will be eliminated. Whichever is colored and red color are eliminated. And remaining we need to write. That is remaining are L2. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. In the next level,
yes,
from
sir.
This L2, we need to form the join operation. So while joining I1, I2, I3. Okay, I1, I2, I3. Then I1, I2, I5. I1, I2, I5. Then I1, I3. I1, I3.
I1.
I5. Correct now. Then I2, I3, I4.
I4.
Next, I2, I3, I5. I2, I4, I5. And I2, I4, I5. So, all these we need to generate. But we have to apply now a priori principle, which says that if there is a item set which is found to be infrequent, then its superset also infrequent. Now you can observe here, I1, I4, if it is infrequent, found to be infrequent, then its superset. Now see, I1 and I4, whichever is coming together, is there any? No. So next is I3, I4 is there together. See, one, this should be eliminated. I3, I4. Then one more, I3 and I5, I3, I5 together, I3, I5 together, right. Then next is, whichever is infrequent, I4 and I5, right. I4 and I5 are infrequent, I4 and I5 are infrequent. So the remaining is only these two, I1, I2, I3. After joining, this is called as a pruning. In pruning step, we need to eliminate, we need to apply the a priori principle, and we need to eliminate the infrequent item. If the item is infrequent, its superset is also infrequent. That's why we are eliminated all these four. Is it clear? Is it clear, Fatima?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How we got this? By eliminating, by doing the joining operation, then eliminating the items which are infrequent. So we'll get I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5. So next we need to scan. And how many times I1, I2, I3 is coming together, means which is occurring in a transaction? I1, I2, I3. Yeah, can you show? Can you tell? I1, I2, I3.
Two times.
Yeah, where it is? Which transaction?
Twice.
One is here, no?
T800.
T800.
Yeah. 900 and 800. Then similarly, I1, I2, I5 once. Then here, I1, I2, I5.
T800.
Yeah. So we need to do the support count. Compare the support count with the minimum support. Minimum support is given as a 2. That's why L is the three-item frequent item set. Next possibility is L4. So while doing L4, what we'll get? I1, I2, I3, I5. Only one set we get, right? But is there any support? How much is the support? Support is
2.
Only one for the next level. After doing this, when we are generating C4, what is the value? C4. Here you have generated C3 now. Like this, C4, if you are generating C4, what value you will get? I1, I2,
I3. I5.
Correct, no?
I5.
Yes.
How many times I1, I2, I3, I5 is occurring?
Once.
Only once. Whether it is greater than once. Minimum support?
Yes.
No.
Lesser than.
That's why our algorithm will end. Now our frequent item sets will be three frequent item sets will be this one, these two. I1, I2, I3. I1, I2, I5. Two frequent item set will be I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I5, I2, I3, I2, I4, I2, I5. One frequent item set is I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. Now in the next, what we are going to do is we need to find out the confidence. How much is the confidence? The confidence value will be given. So that we will discuss in the subsequent class, maybe in the next class when I'll communicate to you when is the next class. I hope it is clear to you, or you are having any doubt.
Clear, sir.
Clear, no?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, Nikita, what do you mean by support count? Nikita is not answering. I think she is online or not. Chanda, what do you mean by support count? Yeah, Shahala, what do you mean by support count?
Don't know. Chaitresh. Chaitresh, you are there? Chaitresh.
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Yeah, what do you mean by support count?
Frequency of item set.
Frequency of item set. Frequency of items found in the transaction. How many times the item sets are found in a transaction. I hope it is clear to you. Whether the class is useful?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. In the next class, we'll discuss some more topic. So, thank you for listening.
Yes, sir.
So.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you can log out now. Attendance, sir.
Attendance.
I can see from here. It is already recorded. For attendance, sir, you are appearing.
No, sir.
Many are appearing for attendance, but these problems, no, it is difficult to solve.
Knowledge.
Yeah. So, if possible, I will send today one more problem. So, you have to solve it. Try to understand and solve
it. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Thank you for listening, and you can log out now.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
You're thank welcome. You, sir.
Yeah, bye.
Thank you, sir.